Welcome back, friends. You know the drill. As you see, Star Trek, yada yada. We are at the first of a good few obnoxious puzzles. This one is actually pretty easy compared to the ones coming up. Basically, those buttons in the background are going to be used to hopefully get a character from this side of the room to the other. Now, see what happens if I press this one. Okay. Let's just stay here and... wrong button. I think this is the one. Whoops, I guess not. Oh, hey, that's actually handy. No, I think this one. No. Yes. This one. And then this one. I don't think we go all the way down. I think we'll just go through. Let's try this one. Nope. But I think we were on the right track. So, this one. Was it? No, I think it was all the other way down. I think. It's all the way up. Nope, it was across. Well, I'm sorry about that. But my sound cut out for whatever reason, and I didn't know it until I was done with the video. You'll hopefully forgive me, but then again, if you've made it this far, you've likely already forgiven me, for which I am incredibly appreciative. By this video, I've gone through 3 or 4 different software programs just trying to get this to work. I am not the most technologically inclined, and... well, I won't say I was tricked into using Ubuntu. It wasn't what I was told it was. And long story short, like most Unix flavors, I suppose, it is mainly for people who know what they're doing, and I don't. Which is humorous. It's kind of like a monkey banging at a typewriter. It's cute, almost charming, but ultimately results are random. Anyway, yes, this was a very irritating puzzle, although not anywhere near as irritating as the ones that will follow it. It's actually a pretty basic puzzle, although for the... I shouldn't say basic. It's basic in premise. It's, you know, you as you can see, you pick various buttons to hopefully get your main character, in this case I'm using Data, from one side of the room to the other. Now, yeah. Thankfully, there aren't really any repercussions You just get, if you fall, for lack of a better term, you just get dumped back to the beginning. Hopefully you remember how to get as far as you were before. This is actually somewhat lenient, and I realize I should just call it obnoxious and irritating and so on and so forth, but it's actually pretty lenient because it's so short. It's only, what, like 6 or 7 button presses, I think. Now, the later one is not so lenient. And, yeah. Which you'll see because we get there in a few moments to muck around with it at the end of the video. And there's one later on. I don't remember if I talked about it before it stopped recording sound or not. But there's one later on that basically involves transporters. I have never gotten through that easily. It is mostly trial and error for me, to be honest. Well, somewhere between trial and error and doing things somewhat randomly and hoping something works. Let's see, yeah, we just finished the puzzle. And I don't understand why this was here. You can't get through that door unless someone is standing back there. Okay. There's no rule. And all it does is make you take an extra moment or two. That's really it. You can go in there and prop open the doors by standing there, and then bring your last crew member back. No real point to it. The next room that we just get into here, it's somewhat similar. It's not, there's no real point to it. It's not as dangerous, really. If you touch those squares that are glowing, I guess, then yes, it saps a fair amount of health, but in that room, they're incredibly easy to avoid. It just, I don't know, I suppose it's letting you know, I guess, what's coming up, but I don't know. It's honestly, this entire level, for lack of a better term, has weird spikes and dips in difficulty. Most of the levels, the incline in difficulty is not quite so jagged, for lack of a better term. And here I'm going back just to make sure I didn't miss anything on the wall. Because, like, most, I guess the term is isometric, or isometric? I forget right now. RPGs, there's nothing of interest on the walls you can't see. There might be something of interest on the walls you can see. Anyway, as I was saying, this level has weird difficulty spikes. Some parts will be incredibly difficult, some incredibly easy. Like this part of this level right here is much more. Let's see, that room, nothing in it at all, is just there. Like, okay, whatever. But the room right there, it's kind of in the middle, which it makes, which fits. I should say, fits. But, like, the room with nothing in it at all. Why was that even there? Or the first room with these kind of glowy bits. Okay, yes, we've reached the other side where there's another one of those, get from here to there puzzles. And this one, I think this is the only, the last one, rather, since I don't know how it is, huh? I believe that's the last one. I believe the next major movement, I suppose, movement-related puzzle, is that irritating transporter puzzle. If memory serves, and I haven't played this again in years, numerous years. quickly, it's not just getting through the transporter puzzle and then going on about your business. It's, I think you have to go through it a few different times because you have to get something from this room or whatever, and then go back through it, and then get something from that room, or do something else, and it's something. Excuse me. Now, here, the long pause was, I think I was telling you guys something. His words were, I believe in something, I really don't know. I know that I was trying to remember how to get across. I thought, and I still think, because as of my making this audio file that will be laid over the nothing that's currently there, I have not continued on with the game yet. I still believe that is, well, okay, maybe not that, but I still believe that it's on Beverly Crusher's side of the room that we started. Of course, watch me be completely wrong. That would just be funny. Yeah, here I'm trying to jog my memory by opening up basic entryways, for lack of a better term, and looking at them, seeing if they jog my memory or whatever else. And then, yeah, there I looked at it and decided to pet, apparently. Decided to just say, you know what, I have a feeling it's on the left. That's what we're going with. I mean, I haven't played this, I can't even remember. I'm going to say around 10 years, I think. So I used to have this on Genesis, on an actual physical cartridge, and then things happened, I moved around, and no longer have it there. Yeah, this begins the first of, I'm quite sure, many old cruds and starting over. I honestly would not be surprised if my attempt to get through just this puzzle takes up the entirety of the next video, maybe even one or two more after that. It's just that kind of video. Or, puzzle. Yeah, I'm making sense wrong. See, that seems right to me, though. The two squares, I suppose I should say octagons, but whatever. Of course, you're not going to be completely wrong. About that time, so thank you for watching, thank you for playing up with me, and hope you enjoy it, and see you next time.